Hi, my name is Prashanth Elangovan. Welcome to the Flight School channel. In this video, part of the private pilot series, I will be covering pilot control inputs and aircraft movement. By the end of this discussion, you will know exactly what are the control mechanisms that a pilot uses and how this makes the aircraft go up and down and left and right. You will understand what a pitch is, roll, yaw, bank, center of gravity, and the various axes around which the aircraft turns. After you watch this video, try answering the questions given in the description below. This will not only reinforce your learning, but also help you with your theoretical and practical exams, such as a computer-based knowledge test, skill test, or a check ride. Or do it just for fun. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to make sure you don't miss out on our videos. And now, control inputs and aircraft movement coming up. If one was to describe how a car or a bus moves, the answer to that might be quite simple. Buses and cars have the capability to move forward, backward or reverse, and change direction by turning left or right. But when it comes to describing how an aircraft moves, it becomes a bit more complex than that. For example, normally aircraft are not designed to maneuver backward, that is, reverse itself like a car. But it can maneuver in ways that a car or a bus simply cannot, such as getting off the ground and flying up and down. To understand how an aircraft moves or maneuvers, we have to get familiar with a few concepts and terminologies, such as rotation, axis, horizon, attitude, pitch, roll, yaw, bank, and center of gravity. Let's start with something as simple as rotation. Rotation can be described as the action of rotating, turning, or revolving of any body about its center. An example that immediately comes to mind is the rotation of a planet revolving or turning about its center, which then leads us conveniently to what an axis is. If you look at the example of the Earth rotating, many of us have learnt in school that it rotates about its axis. So what is an axis? An axis is an imaginary line about which a body rotates. In this example of the Earth rotating, the axis also becomes the north and the south pole of the planet. Keep in mind, anytime a body turns, a turn is just a small part of a full rotation, therefore has an axis of its own. When pilots fly in the sky, how do they know visually which way is up or down? After all, up or down for us is normally based on a point of reference, such as the ground. Pilots use a fixed reference in the sky when flying with outside visual reference. This fixed reference is called a horizon. As the name suggests, it is horizontal. It is where the earth and sky seem to meet, forming a horizontal line in the distance. Using the horizon, pilots orient the aircraft. This is usually done by positioning the aircraft's nose, the base of the windscreen, or the cowling, relative to the horizon outside, from the pilot's perspective. This orientation of the aircraft relative to the horizon is called the attitude of the aircraft. An aircraft may have a nose up attitude, in which case the nose is above the horizon from the pilot's point of view, or a nose down attitude, in which case the nose is below the horizon from the pilot's point of view. When the aircraft has a nose up or a nose down attitude relative to the horizon, we describe this as a pitch up or a pitch down attitude. And the change in attitude from nose up to nose down or vice versa is called pitching up or pitching down. The fuselage of the aircraft, being mostly cylindrical in shape, is able to revolve or rotate about its center, like a rolling pin that rolls. This movement is called a roll. When the aircraft rolls to the left or right from the pilot's perspective, this changes the angle between the horizon and the aircraft's reference point. One might conclude that an aircraft's roll amounts to the aircraft turning, but this is not entirely accurate. Think about this. You may have seen an aircraft perform aerobatic maneuvers where it is rolling while still flying forward without a change in direction. Like this, you can see the aircraft is rolling, but the nose is not turning and is not pointing to a different direction. In this case, a roll can be independent of a change in direction. When it comes to a change in direction, take for example a car turning, the nose of the car is changing direction. But you can tell the car is not rolling when it turns. Likewise, an aircraft can simply change direction, that is, point its nose to a different direction without rolling. This change in direction, when the nose moves left to right or right to left, is called a yaw. While a yaw is independent of a roll, normally when an aircraft turns, it both yaws and rolls in the same direction it turns. This combined movement of yaw and roll in a turn is called a bank. So when we describe an aircraft turning, we normally call it banking into a turn. Now that we know the various aircraft movements such as pitch, roll and yaw, let's take a look at their corresponding axes around which they move. We already know an axis is an imaginary line about which a body rotates. The pitching movement, that is the nose moving up and down, is said to be around the x-axis or the lateral axis of the aircraft. The lateral axis is an imaginary line running from wingtip to wingtip. Therefore, pitching is around the lateral axis. Roll is said to be around the y-axis or the longitudinal axis. This is an imaginary line going through the fuselage from nose tip to tail tip. Therefore, roll is around the longitudinal axis. And finally, yaw is said to be around the z or z-axis or the vertical axis. This is the imaginary line that goes through the aircraft from above the aircraft to below the aircraft, vertically. Therefore, yaw is around the vertical axis. An aircraft is said to pitch, roll and yaw about its center of gravity. To explore this, let's first understand what center of gravity is. Take for example this pen. Let's try and find the center of gravity of this pen. This point where I can balance the pen without it sloping in one direction or the other is where the center of gravity of this pen is located. Therefore, we can describe the center of gravity as the point at which a body is able to balance in equilibrium. CG is the abbreviation used for center of gravity and is denoted by this symbol. Now that we know what CG is, the aircraft is said to pitch, roll and yaw about its center of gravity. Let's see how a pilot controls the aircraft and maneuvers it. In the cockpit, pilots can apply control inputs to steer and maneuver the aircraft with the help of the control column, the rudder pedals, and the trim. The control column, or simply called a yoke, appears a lot like a steering wheel of a car. But unlike the steering wheel of a car, the yoke can not only move left and right, but it can also move forward and backward as well. With this control column, both pitching and rolling is achieved. By moving it forward and backward, the elevator of the aircraft is actuated and the aircraft pitches up or down. Moving it to the left or right, a bit like using a steering wheel in a car, actuates the ailerons and the aircraft rolls left or right. Moving the rudder pedals by feet actuates the rudder and yaws the aircraft left or right. A bank is accomplished by combining the roll and the yaw together with the aileron and the rudder control. The controls, such as the control column and the rudder pedals, are linked to the control surfaces, such as the elevator, aileron and the rudder, by rods, cables, pulleys and sometimes chains. To summarize, pitch is around the lateral axis, actuated by the elevator, with the pilot inputs moving the control column forward and back. Roll is around the longitudinal axis, actuated by the ailerons, with the pilot inputs moving the control column left or right. And yaw is around the vertical axis, actuated by the rudder, with the pilot inputs to the rudder pedals. While flying an aircraft, pilots also use another control called a trim. This is used to relieve the aerodynamic pressures or forces felt by the pilot's hands when changing and holding pitch attitudes. Use of trim will be covered in detail in a separate lesson. Now you know what is a rotation, a horizon, center of gravity, the axes of the aircraft, the various attitudes such as pitch, roll, yaw, bank, and the control surfaces used by pilots to input control and change the attitude of the aircraft. How about try answering the questions in the description below and test yourself? If you enjoyed this video, please support our channel by giving us a thumbs up, do leave your comment below, and share this video with your friends. Until next time, keep safe and happy landings.